and got it bumping.
Trust the process. Feel like it's falling down. You can't just quit, you know you gotta. Trust the process. You better fix your crown. We kings and queens, you know we gotta. Trust the process. Trust the process. Go with your heart, you gotta trust the process.
It's another week of the process. Today is Monday, March the 7th. And just at home today. Because I usually take Mondays off to try to get my stuff ready for the week. And meaning performance-wise, know what shows I'm going to be on. Try to get an idea of what material I'm going to work on for that particular week. And I usually do that via writing. Writing is an important thing for me. I know a lot of comics don't. I should say they don't, but a lot of comics say they don't write at all. Some say they just jot things down. Others write full, long jokes and then break them down. I kind of do a little bit of all of it. Sometimes I don't write. Sometimes I jot it down. And sometimes I write these long monologues. And then I try to have to break it down. But I think it's important to write. I think writing is a critical part of being a comedian. You have to be able to know where you're going with it. There are very few, in my opinion, there are very few comedians in this business that can just get up there and talk. And do well with that. They have to have, I think everyone has to have some type of idea of what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. So my process in regards to that is I recently bought a whiteboard, which is over there. And it has my, for this particular thing, it has my Little Rock set list. And for that, it has things that I feel like are ready to go that I don't really need to work on that much. I know what I'm doing with that bit. I know where I'm going with that bit. There are things that are possible bits that I want to do. Or new bits that I'm working on, and it's things that are just out, things that I know are not going to work based off of the repetition that I've done it on stage, and it just doesn't get the feedback that I think would do well. So I have my whiteboard. I use my Mac to write down the longer bits, longer jokes, so that way I can go back in and then revamp that and bounce that off of my other comedian friends who do well in this business. And try to figure out, again, what I need to take out and not to be so wordy in other instances and try to break that down to where you get into the bit a lot faster. And, of course, the trusty phone. I use Samsung Notes on my phone so that way, even when I'm out and about during the day, if I think of an idea, that's when I'll jot the idea down and then put maybe some sub notes in between that. So that way I know what I'm going to write when I get home. So today is about writing. It's late in the evening, but we still got work to do because y'all know this is the process. All right, so tonight I'm performing in the Arts District, and it's a book show, so I'm ready to do this thing. But I got to be honest with you. Like I said, the process is about giving y'all a glimpse into everything that I deal with preparing for a show or just comedically in general. And I gotta say, the past couple of days I've been real pensive. Like just in deep thought with things that happened in the past, things I wanna see done in the future. And sometimes in that process, it takes you away comedically or creatively from thinking about what you have to do. So as they always say, any entertainer will always tell you, man, nobody cares about your personal problems, but you step on that stage, you have to deliver. So that's what we're going to do tonight. Is we're going, as soon as I touch the mic, it's showtime. It's time to get down to business and just do what I do best. So wipe that stuff out of my mind, clear my mind. Always get to a show early so that way I can get a vibe of the show, clear my mind, and then hit the stage and let it rip. So let's go. It's 18 Ben tonight in downtown Las Vegas, the Arts District. Let's go have a good time.
Trust the process. Feel like it's falling down. You can't just quit, you know you gotta. Trust the process.
So I just finished up the comedy show, and I must say, I told y'all going in that in the past couple of days I've been feeling pensive, like a lot of random thoughts going through my head that didn't have me in a comedic mood. But once that mic is turned on and it's time to do what I do, then I feel so much better. Like, comedy really is my drug of choice. Like, there's nothing like it. To hear people's laughter, to to, you can even have a bad day or an off day. I shouldn't say a bad day. I don't have bad days anymore. You can have an off day and still go on stage and enjoy yourself. It's the best feeling in the world. It's something that I do not take that for granted. I take this job very seriously. It was a pleasure to be on stage tonight, to hear people's laughs, and not only hear their laughs, but just immediately come out of my funk and get back to business. Tomorrow, we do the same. See y'all later.
He had that white woman in the back stairs. She was about to get up there on the door. She was like, I don't know what the fuck. I didn't want to get too sorry. He was like, I don't know nothing about none of this. He didn't. Ray Lyle was giving a PSA for being single. Like, I ain't never heard like that in my entire life. He ripped every woman. Like, do you plan on getting any type of shit?
It is March the 12th. I haven't seen y'all video-wise since the night of March the 9th. However, I have been still working. Thursday the 10th, I was doing some writing. Last night, I was at the LA Comedy Club and then backstage bar at Billiards doing some support, supporting of my comedian friends. As part of the process, it's always good to still be on the scene, I think, for any entertainer, for your craft. It's good to be on the scene and not only support, but see what your peers are doing and seeing how they're progressing as well as continued motivation for yourself. Tonight I am at Laugh After Dark. Laugh After Dark is one of the dopest, hottest shows in the city of Vegas. It is well produced by Robert and Kelsey, hosted by Charlie Wilson. Yeah, not that Charlie Wilson, this Charlie Wilson. But it's always a good show. They have the Fremont Funk Band there that plays good old school music. It's more upscale. It is a nicer dressed function. So I gotta go get my wardrobe right. So I'm headed out now to go do that. I swear I hate shopping because I never know what I'm looking for. I just be waiting on something to jump out at me. It ain't there yet. Gotta keep searching. So the other part of the process, I finished my shopping early, so I got my fit ready for tonight's Laugh After Dark show. But the other part of the process is making sure your body is right. And I'm trying to lean out and tone up so I can look great physically on stage. So the workout is on today.
Put your crown on and become a king. Put your crown on and stop asking for other people to make you great. And you take it. And no, this will not be given to you. This will not just be handed to you. You're gonna have to take it.
So, after a good workout, I sit in the sauna for about 5 to 10 minutes. And then it's on home to rest and relax and get my mind ready to put on a good show tonight. I can't wait. I'm always excited about those shows where I know people are coming to have a good time. They want to have a good time. They want to laugh. So it's going to be a great time tonight. I think I'll take y'all with me. See y'all later.
We got Laugh After Dark. Let's go see what it looks like. We might be good. chat. I don't know how we're gonna figure this out, but this requires further inspection. I think you gotta dive deep into this. Yo, that's not the brain stuff.
Trust the process. Feel like it's falling down. You can't just quit, you know you gotta. Trust the process. You better fix your crown. We kings and queens, you know we gotta. Trust the process. Trust the process. Go with your heart, you gotta trust the process.